the occasion of the 72nd Republic Day, I extend my greetings to the people of Andhra Pradesh and I salute the founding fathers of our nation who have struggled to make India free and the architect of our constitution which has laid down the guiding principle for us to progress with dignity and decorum. It is prudent here to recall what Prime Minister Narendra Modi had recently said, quoting legendary Telugu playwright and reformist Gurjada Appa Rao by saying, Desamante Mati Kwadoi, Desamante Manu Suloya. Very aptly, the preamble of our constitution begins with we people. More than 7 decades ago, on this day, our constitution has come into effect, which has placed on our shoulders the responsibility to adhere to justice, liberty, equality, and fraternity, which are the main tenets of democracy. To the darkness, nobody has tested it. It's looking dark. The government has clear-cut agenda of all-round development of the state. It laid emphasis on education, medical and health, agriculture and welfare. The government has launched numerous schemes to benefit all the sections of the people. The beneficiaries are selected in a transparent manner without any discrimination of caste, creed, religion or political affiliation, and the schemes are implemented in 100% saturation mode. Before listing our the details of the welfare schemes, the acumen with which our government had handled the COVID pandemic merits praise. We have passed through testing times. With the outbreak of COVID pandemic, and my government had effectively handled the situation, taking measures which have won accolades from across the country. With vaccination rolling out in days back, run has been smooth and government has put in place the necessary infrastructure. Which includes storage and movement mechanism of the vaccines. We have to respect all faiths, and that is what our tradition has been. The recent distractions from the guiding principle laid down in the preamble of our constitution are very distressing. The government is very firm in safeguarding the social fabric which is spun by the colorful yarn of various faiths that reflects unity in diversity. While the government believes this principle, in letter and spirit, some vested interests have been trying to whip up passion by instigating and restoring to unsavory incidents which are crude, meaningless, and are blessed with ulterior motives. Desecration, vandalism, arson, and all sorts of acts of insanity have no place in our society, and those responsible for the aberrations will be dealt with firmly by all means to restore peace and harmony in the state, which has been making rapid strides in the term of welfare and development. Housing for all, Navaratnalu. We established Vaikuntha Ekadasi and Christmas on December 25 with the government taking up the huge task of distributing nearly 31 lakh house sites in the poor and also begin the construction of houses. Such a program was never held in the country earlier. There are some hurdles for implementation of welfare schemes. However, government went ahead and distributed the house sites quotas in all litigation-free areas. It was not construction of houses, but a building of habitations with the 30.75 lakh beneficiaries, of which 28.30 lakh houses are coming up in 17,000 YSL Jagannanna layouts. In the first phase, construction of 15.60 lakh houses has commenced with a cost of 28,084 crores, and the remaining 12.70 lakh houses will be taken up soon. The government has acquired 68,361 acres of land worth ₹23,535 crores, and the beneficiaries